Really excited about this week's edition of Ride Smart. We're right in the middle of the Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge. Hey, if you love cowboys, you like horses, and you like action, hey, we got it all going on right here. We're gonna put these guys through their paces, and we got all kinds of champion cowboys and top horses that are gonna go to work. Hey, this is something you're gonna like. You're gonna wanna track it all the way, and guess what? We got $16,000 up for grabs for these guys and championship buckles as well. Hey, get to know these guys, pull for your champion, and that's all coming up right now on Ride Smart.
The Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge on Ride Smart is brought to you in part by Ranch Hand Spray Lubricant, Total Equine, unparalleled excellence in nutrition, Cactus Saddlery, Bradshaw Hay, Pro Earth Animal Health, makers of EquiSure, and by Diller Hay Feeders.
I want to tell you about the hay-saving feeders made by Diller that we've been using for several years here on the Double Horn Ranch. These feeders are designed for large, round, and square bales. They feature a wide body design and hay basket with end panels, which limit consumption and waste, which saves you money. With their heavy-duty construction, every Diller feeder is covered by a 3-year warranty, and it's made right here in the USA. For more information on Diller horse feeders, go to DillerEquine.com. Cactus Western Saddle is a true work of art that begins with Herman Oak leather and combines the finest craftsmanship and materials available. Each piece is handcrafted by master saddle makers to be functional, authentic, and attractive. Cactus Saddlery, we understand exactly what you expect from your saddle and build it to fit both you and your horse. See the complete line of Cactus Saddles at your local Cactus Saddlery dealer or visit them online at cactussaddlery.com. I want to tell you about a great new product that I'm completely sold on, EquiSure. Hey, this is the product that neutralizes the acid in your horse's stomach and takes down the acidic level. That means a happier, healthier, calmer horse. Whether you're showing horses, traveling, or trail riding, whatever, this is a product that I carry with me all the time, and it's insurance for that healthy horse. Hey, check it out. It's a product that you'll love, you'll use, and you won't want to be without. EquiSure. The men that I chose for this, they really are the real deal. Cole Cameron, Bruce Cameron, these guys are got my blood running through their veins. Jim Sharp, his partner, Ted Noose, both those guys, I guarantee you, they always come first place. Clint Hopping, Greg Gansko from Oklahoma, and talk about humor and a lot of fun. Runt Ragath, Chris Redden. Now you talk about some real working cowboys and really authentic. Well, we're starting off with a bang this week. We're going to do a water crossing, about belly deep, almost to where they're swimming. Some of them will be. Then they got to race down about 300 yards, pick up their partner on a rescue race, come back double, recross the water up top to the finish. Our first team, the Red Rangers. Here we go with the Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge. On your mark, get set, go. All right. Runt Ragath, and I tell you what, attacking that water, they got to stay right between those red cones. You can see that horse having to do a little bit of swimming. Now, we're looking for great horsemanship skills, but this is a timed event. Boy, and if you watched last week, you know what a top hand this particular cowboy is. He's all the way from Missouri. The cowboy he's picking up is his longtime partner, Chris Redden, the national champion this year in extreme cowboy racing. Runt Ragath, a 2-time world champion of extreme cowboy racing, also 2-time winner at the Calgary Stampede. Look at them riding. They are bearing down and coming in, and they got a great clip going, really taking care of their horse. Now they got to go right back into the water, and they're wasting no time. What a nice job. Excellent work. Whole little bucking going on, grabbing the horse. They got to get up, and time right there.
Whenever Runt picked me up there, I told him to get his foot out of the stirrup, and he had it hung clear up in front of his breast collar, so there wasn't no chance of me having to hit his foot getting in the stirrup. And when we hit that water, I told Ron, I said, Ron, we're about to get to the edge of the water. I'm fixing to get off. And he says, yeah, you're going to get off here in a minute, because we were starting to lunge pretty heavy then.
Well, we're here with the green team, Greg Gansko, who got those extra bonus points, but they're sitting in last place with only 15 points. Greg, you know what you got to do. This is a tough one. Here we go again. Guys, timers, on your mark. Get set, go. All right, Greg Gansko, I mean, he gives that horse the boots right there, and he is not wasting any time going through that water. He is attacking this course, coming out, getting that horse ducking and diving just a little bit. Now he's getting lined out. Now he's beelining for that windmill. His partner down there, oh yeah, Clint Hopping, an excellent cowboy. And all these cowboys are true cowboys. They're working cowboys, each one of them. Now, tall and lean, getting in the saddle. They got us hold tight, and they got to get themselves back. Now, this horse is riding double. A lot of these horses are not necessarily used to it. These cowboys did not know what these events would be when they showed up here, so not a chance to really practice. But I tell you what, he is covering the mail, absolutely. Not even slowing down coming into the water here. Boy, nice job. Here they come, lock and load, coming to the top, trying to get off. Off they go, get on up, get on up. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get up and time right there. That was pretty darn wild. I tell you, you guys were attacking, and Clint, you hit the deck right there. You're a little slow getting up. Are you feeling all right?
I think I pushed him, and it gave him.
I mean, I went flying forward.
That's good.
I think you got a spur in the air or something.
I tell you what, they weren't holding back a lick. All right, we're moving to the bull team. These guys are in second place. Jim Sharp in the saddle right here. You can see this is pretty wild and western, Jim. All right, let's see what you got. Take care of yourself and your horse. We're going again. On your mark, get set and go. All right, world champion bull rider, Jim Sharp, 2 times champ of the world, moving in on his little bay horse. Now, this guy's an excellent cowboy. I see him in a lot of good brandings, and he really goes deep into the water. That horse having to swim a stride or two, and he comes out now, making a mark and heading right into the windmill, right across the pasture. And they are rolling. They are making some horse track. His horse kind of weaving just a little bit right and left, and he's going to pick up his partner, the other world champion bull rider, Mr. Ted Noose. 14 times the NFR consecutively, champion in 1985, having a little trouble getting mounted, and that's going to cost them time, and time is very precious at this point. They have a little trouble getting going. They finally got it together, and let's see if they can keep it together. Now, again, you see that horse moving right and left. His ears are up. He looks pretty comfortable as these cowboys, longtime friends who rode bulls together and won those championships, working it out. All right, here they come. Here comes the water crossing. They'd like to stay on board right here. Look at this little bay horse doing an excellent job. Oh, look at that horse trying to swim. A lot of extra weight on them right there. As they down, they go. Excellent dismount, making it to the top. And time right there for the bull team. Woo-hoo! Dang, that'll take the air right out of it, won't you? Dang, that's tough, isn't it? Y'all had a little trouble getting mounted.
Yeah, my legs are a little short.
A little short. That's why he's a good bull rider, just the right size. Well, we're moving to the number one team. This is the Bandit team, and they're in the lead with 40 points right now. Let's see if you can get it done with the skills and the time that you need to stay in that number one position. On your mark, get set, and go. All right, Bruce Cameron, this is my nephew right here. Did about a 3-year apprenticeship here. Look at that dog trying to follow him. That dog goes everywhere that cowboy goes. There he goes.
Buns did great going into the water and hauling down there. And then, you know, we were trying a little Roy Rogers style get up, and we were trying to get fancy with it, and kind of bit our dust. And that was my horse, you know, he didn't do too well.
You know, we won the first round, so I think we were getting a little cocky there in the second, and I thought it'd be for good TV if I jump on the back of the horse, which, you know, we did practicing, and then I went, you know, to really do it, and then I couldn't get a hold of the cannel, and Buns kind of kicked up, and there I went. So, and anyway, so we loaded up and did the best we could, and I think Buns was a little jumpy because of the whole situation.
Oh, but, yeah, you know, Buns was kind of crow hopping all the way down, and Cole did a good job just to stay on and stick it out.
All right, here they come. they're back in the saddle, you know, and that's true cowboy grit, never weakened one bit. That horse just kind of crow hopping, so it's going to be a slow run. So here you have our guys in number one position having the longest and toughest run. Oh yeah, now this could be interesting here because this horse is kicking up and a little trouble, a little bothered by that passenger in the back. Now again, if they can just get across that water, he goes right through the deepest part. Here he comes, easing right in there, and see if they can get down. The good athletic move by Colt as they come on in and time right there. What happened down there?
I thought he was on and that he wasn't on enough, I guess. So.
Really? Okay. Yeah. And then he tried a second time.
Yeah, and that time he wasn't on again, and that was probably my fault for leaving early, so.
You've been using now Total Equine and Total Bull and Total Canine and Total Deer and Total People Plus.
You know, it's just the way that I want it to be. You know, people comment on my horse, they actually ask me, what are you feeding? Because they got that shine to them. My cattle are better than ever. You know, I'm just coming back from actually getting my back broke, my shoulder, my knee, a horse flipped on me, and I'm back in the saddle doing it all right now. And you know, I want the best, and I feel like with the Total Feed program, I absolutely, without a doubt, have the best. You know, the foundation for any feeding program is a quality hay. Here at the Double Horn Ranch, we trust Bradshaw Hay Company. This is an irrigated and tested hay grown right here in Texas. So when it comes to horse quality hay and great hay for my cattle, I trust the Bradshaw stamp. You know, hay is the foundation every day that we use. And if you're looking for superior hay that can be delivered to you, square or round, trust Bradshaw.
One of my favorite items in the Craig Cameron Cowboy Collection is the Craig Cameron Cowboy Knife. This knife I've had for over 16 years. Use it on the ranch every day. Holds an edge and never falls out. If you're looking for a good knife to carry each and every day, I recommend the Craig Cameron Cowboy Knife.
Well, welcome back. We're in the middle of the Cowboy Challenge. This time we're switching around. This is the Red Ranger team. They're sitting first in this watercross rescue race. But now Chris Redden's in the saddle. Runt Ragged is the man he's going to be rescuing. They're sitting first. Let's see if they can do it again. They'd like to move into first and garner 40 points toward that championship money and buckle. All right, Chris Redden, you're the man. On your mark, get set and go. All right, they got an opportunity to move way up right here now. And this is a great little horse that's Chris riding right here. And you know, this cowboy does day working all the time, really familiar with cattle, excellent horseman, and won the national championship. That's the buckle he's wearing right now in the Extreme Cowboy Association. What a hand he is. Been invited every year to the Calgary Stampede, an invitational only event, the best in the world. And that's what you're watching as he picks up his buddy, and it doesn't take him long to do it. Here he comes locking and loading and weaving through them trees, and they are on the attack again. Watch these guys, I told you, they are some top hands as he slows it down into the water. They go, oh man, look out boys, look out. Horse are coming, here they come, stepping off. Hurry, 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 right there and time. Man, what a run right there for the Red Rangers. You guys, got to tell you, I think they're kicking butt right here today. If you just want me to tell it like it is. You guys, I tell you what, y'all don't like being anywhere but in first place, do you?
Well, we like it. To be.
I tell you what, they're drenched, and I tell you, what a run. And your horse, if you like his front feet, like to went out from under him right there. I tell you what a great job. These guys right now, way out in front, Red Rangers, hey, they're talking business. All right, moving to the green team. I tell you what, they had a hot run going. Clint hopping in the saddle this time. Hey, there's a chance for some big points to garner up. And I know right now you're having to move from one ranch to the other. The money would come in handy. All right, watch this top working cowboy. Here we go again. Green, lean green machine. On your mark, get set, go. All right, Cowboy Challenge. Look at that, a little ducking and diving on that horse, but what a nice job of horsemanship skills to just guide him and keep him pointed right where he needed to go. Clint Hopping right there. You know, his dad was a great cowboy, brother, great cowboy. And these guys run that tradition every day as he heads down there to pick up his partner, Greg Gansko. You know, Greg Gansko, his whole family in rodeo and team roping and horsemanship, living that cowboy life. What a great team. And both these guys have been making us laugh all week long here. Here they come. This is looking really good and really fast. If they can keep it going, I can hear them talking to each other. They're communicating. And I'm Greg Gansko. Look at that. Oh, yeah, nice job. Oh, Lord have mercy. Down they go. Come on, boys. Keep coming. Keep coming. Hurry to the finish line, Greg. To the finish line, Greg. Come on, Greg. Get moving. Don't weaken. Here they come. Up to the top. Help him up. And time right there. Woo-hoo! Lord have mercy. I tell you what, I think they should have backed off the accelerator just a little bit.
Get back. I think Greg should have backed off the french fries at lunch. Put my little horse over in the water. My horse ain't got no hind end. I had nowhere to sit.
I tell you what, that old man, we look like we were stuck in the mud down there.
I
could hear y'all. Were y'all cussing each
Where'd
other?
My hat coming go?
Down. I think that's that
brand
there
new,
it is.
That is a brand new
and
American
that's a
strong.
Brand new American hat right there.
Raz, she's a smaller horse, and we came back really fast. And I was on top of Raz, and Greg was on top of me. And so when we came in there and hit the water, and all of a sudden we're flying back, and I hear my partner saying, "Whoa!" and the horse. You know, she's trying her heart out, but we're going that fast, and I'm going, I know the water's about to hit. I can't see. All I can see is his shirt, and all of a sudden, bam.
Well, things are definitely getting western here on the Double Horn Ranch. I told you this was a cowboy challenge, and right now, got a world champion cowboy in the saddle, Ted Noose, and the bull team headed down there to pick up Jim Sharp. All right, Teddy, on your mark. Get set and go. All right, cowboy off and a going. These are our world champion cowboys in the PRCA. Jim Sharp, two-time bull riding champ. Ted Noose, 1985 champ. Boy, I tell you what, taking his time, crossing it. Well, out he comes. All he needs is kind of a solid run. Wants to just get some points. Because they were in second place. They want to just stay consistent. You know, I keep telling every guy coming out, take care of yourself, take care of your horse, use your skills. And right now, right on the money and looking very consistent. That's what it's all about. You know, as Jim Sharp goes to mount, one of the most athletic guys to ever ride bulls and a cowboy that really believes in staying fit. And he is just about, both these guys, just as strong as a bull. Here they come. Real centered up, really in control, very smooth, using the skills that they need and working together. You know, these guys are good friends, and you see that partnership going right now. Now, right here, he's kind of slowing it down, letting that horse pick his way and find his feet. Here they come right across the water, looking really good. Ted riding in a little hackamore. Jim right where he's supposed to be sitting. Off they come. Stewart gets the horse. They got to make it up there. Come on, cowboys. And time. All right.
You know, my horse is 6 years old, and we hadn't rode her double, I don't think, ever before this event. And she had bucked me off one time, and I really didn't want that on camera. So I was a little conservative, and it was called a banker's run. We just did what we had to do and make a smooth run, and it all turned out.
Well, you know what? You're about the only two guys still dry. All right. Great work by the bull team. That's consistency. We got one team left to go.
Slow runs don't make good TV, y'all.
We're moving to the last team. This is the Bandit team that was number one in the last event. Now they had a little trouble this time. Cole Cameron back in the saddle, headed down there to get Bruce. All right, Cole, on your mark, get set and go. All right, he's going to have a talk to me about having just a smooth run right here. Boy, he said it really kind of hurt his back a little bit, and this horse kind of back and forth right here. Really needs to catch that right rein quicker when that horse turns. Got to catch it. There he is. You know what? And that was an excellent job of horsemanship that you saw right then. really liked what he did right there. Get that horse to cross. He's looking for the blue or left pedal. He's got to find it right there and having a lot of trouble on this water run. And this is not an easy event, but you know, in any trail ride or anything like that, so much of the time you've got to cross water. So again, Cole having to really take a hold of this horse. He really finally got his stirrup back just then. I'm sure that feels a lot more secure to him. So again, the guys that won in the last one having a lot of trouble on the second stage of this Cowboy Challenge. All right, he's down there. That's his cousin he's picking up right now. And again, this horse hadn't done a lot of this type of work, and this was that horse that I told you can have a little dab of a mean streak. So let's just see what happens and see if they can get it to happen and just make it on home. All right, boy, and I tell you what, they're kind of picking up the pace, and this is actually looking very good at this point. You see little Cricket right there, Bruce's little stock dog, right behind him, staying loyal all the way. Boy, here comes that water crossing again. And boy, they got to stick with it. They're having a hard time right there. Really need to shorten up. They're going to take that water any way they can get it. Here they come. You know what? I like it. I like the way they've hung tough. Here comes Cole hitting the ground right there, and time right there. Woo! I tell you what, I think that took a lot of heart right there, because I know Cole, you know, that case, he's talking about rib hurting and knee hurting, but you know what? No backup, no quit. Hey, what a classic old-time Western day we've had here on this water crossing. And you know what I like? These cowboys never weaken, never back up, all heart. And that's what true horsemanship and cowboying's all about. Craig Cameron Horsemanship Clinics at the Double Horn Ranch are designed to fit each rider's individual needs. 5 different round pens, corrals, arenas, and the original Extreme Cowboy Race Course make great horses and riders.
I learned more in 3 days than I have in the first 35 years I rode a horse.
It was like having a private lesson. Even though it was a group, it was like having a private lesson.
Yeah, you'll wear out the Wrangler in your jeans, I tell you.
Advance your horsemanship and come ride like a champion with me at the Double Horn Ranch. Craig Cameron Horsemanship Clinics are on the road and rolling strong and coming to a town near you. Check out these dates. Coming in last place on a water and rescue race right there was the team that was first place in the first stage, and that was the Bandits. But amazingly, because they had 40 points last time, they're still at 50 points, so they're deep in the hunt. All right, coming in and picking up 20 points, and that's the Bull team, and they're also at 50 points. The green team picked up 30 points. They're at 45 points. And then the big winners for the day, Red Rangers. They not only got the 40 points, they got the 5 bonus points for the fastest single individual time by Chris Redden. And they move into the lead by, 15 points with 65 points. There's your champions for the day right there. Good job, Cowboys. What a run we had right there. Okay.
Why didn't you go all the way in?
Friends, guys, I'm glad I didn't go in there.
Yeah.
I'd like to be able to wear my boots tomorrow. Well, that wraps it up for the water rescue, and you can see it really was a true cowboy challenge. You know, these guys were really putting their heart and soul into it, but we've got a lot of more tough challenges up front. You won't want to miss one single one, and that's all coming to you, as usual, on the best show on RFD TV, Ride Smart. Looks pretty damn good. Good job, Chris.
Greg, you tell me. Yes, sir, I do.
Look, he's got it shaped up pretty good.
Hey, it looks good.
Back in the game.
next time on the Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge.
They're the oldest guys, and I don't want y'all having a heart attack during this deal, because this cowboy chore list, as you can see, is mighty tough.
Hey, one more. Go, Bruce, go. Go, Bruce, go. Go, go, go. All right, good. Okay. Oh, look at that. All right, here we go. These guys are dipping. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on. Oh, yeah. Now, we know these guys are familiar with water right here. Next time on the Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge.
The Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge on Ride Smart is brought to you in part by Ranch Hand Spray Lubricant, Total Equine, unparalleled excellence in nutrition, Cactus Saddlery, Bradshaw Hay, Pro Earth Animal Health, makers of Equisure, and by Diller Hay Feeders. Prize money provided by Taylor Bit and Rental. Jeans provided by KimesRanch.com.
I think they're taking a little bit too much time to get on their horses, so I have a trick up my sleeve. We'll see if it works. I'm gonna play the young card here. We'll see. Might not.